In this video, we'll study about the neurons in detail. As you all know, the nervous tissue consists of excitable parenchyma cells, the neurons, and non-excitable neuroglia and ependymal cells in the central nervous system, and Schwann cells and capsular cells in the peripheral nervous system. The mature neuron do not divide by mitosis after birth except the bipolar olfactory neurons in the nasal mucous membrane and some neurons of the hippocampus. The neurons are the structural and functional units of the central nervous system. Each neuron consists of a central body or the soma, and you have the processes or the neurites, and the neurites are of two kinds, one or more dendrites which convey the impulses towards the soma, and a single axon which conveys the impulses away from the soma. So these processes are cytoplasmic extensions. First we'll see about the cell body or soma. It contains a nucleus and a surrounding cytoplasm or pericardium, and it is limited outside by the plasma membrane. Next we'll see the structure of the cell body. First we'll see about the nucleus. So this is a nucleus. The nucleus is central in position. It's a large and vesicular and contains a prominent nucleolus. Sometimes the nucleus is eccentric in position in injury or fatigue of the nerve cells. Healthy sympathetic ganglion cell, however, contain an eccentric nucleus. In normal female, you have a plano-convex heterochromatin mass. The sex chromatin or bar body is present beneath the nuclear membrane. Next, we'll study about the cytoplasm of the pericardium, and it consists of Nissl bodies. So these are the Nissl bodies. So these are deeply stained angular bodies stained with basic dye, present in the cytoplasm and extend into the dendrites. But the Nissl bodies do not extend into the axon because they are unable to percolate in the axoplasm due to the crowding of the neurofibrils. These bodies are more numerous in motor neurons than in sensory neurons. Nissl bodies are composed of closely packed ribosome granules combined with iron and attached to the rough surfaced endoplasmic reticulum. These bodies help synthesis of new proteins and enzymes to meet up the metabolic demands of the neurons and maintain a continuous axoplasmic flow to the end of the axon. When the nerve cell is injured or fatigued, the Nissl bodies disappear, and this process is known as chromatolysis, which is a reversible process within certain limits. Next, the cytoplasm consists of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum extends in all processes but more in the axon, reaching the terminal ends. So this helps in the transmission of neurochemical substances and breaks up into synaptic vesicles at the terminal ends of the axons. The next structure we'll see in the cytoplasm is the mitochondria. The mitochondria are numerous double membrane rod-like structure which is present in the entire cytoplasm, and they all extend into all the processes. The next structure present in the cytoplasm is the Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus is situated close to the nucleus and consists of closely packed parallel arrays of intercommunicating smooth membranous vesicles. The apparatus helps storing and releasing the neurosecretion as found in some nerve cells. The next structures we'll see is the lysosomes. The lysosomes are thick-walled membranous vesicles and they contain hydrolytic enzymes and acid phosphatase. The lysosome phagocytose exogenous offensive agents and hydrolyze the nacelle bodies during chromatolysis. The next structure we'll see is the neurofilaments. The neurofilaments are arranged in a plexiform manner in the cell body and it extends into all the processes. The neurofilaments and the microtubules crowd together at the axon hillock. They act as an internal support of the neurons. The next structure we'll see is the microtubules or the neurotubules. So these are elongated membrane bound tubules which are found in the soma and extend into the dendrites and the axons. Kinesins, a class of proteins, are found to move along the outer surface of the microtubules in both directions, and this may assist contractility of the neurons. The centrioles do exist within the soma of all neurons as observed in electromicrograph, although the cells do not divide in postnatal life. The centrioles help in the regeneration of the cytoplasmic microtubules. Next, we'll see about the neuromelanin. So the neuromelanin are the degradation products of catecholamine synthesis and are more abundant in the cell bodies of the substantia nigra of midbrain. The neuromelanin helps synthesis of dopamine, which acts as a neurotransmitter substance. The next pigment we'll see is the lipofuscin. It is a senility pigment made up of essentially of fatty material. It appears as a small clumps of granules and this increases with age. This pigment appears as wear and tear residual bodies of cytoplasmic organelles, and the hydrolytic enzymes of lysosome possess some role in its formation. Next, we'll see about the pigment granules and other inclusions. First, we'll see about the lipochrome. So this produces yellow color of the neuron and it is more abundant in old age. Next, we'll see about the metallic elements such as copper, which are rich in locus ceruleus, imparting a bluish color, zinc in the hippocampus, and iron in the oculomotor nucleus. These elements may form a part of special enzyme systems. Next, we'll see about the plasma membrane. The plasma membrane of the dendrites and the soma contain the receptor protein molecules, which are activated by transmitters from other neurons. The activated receptors causes the resting potential of the dendrites and the soma to be altered, either raised or lowered. The altered or graded potential is conveyed to the initial segment of the axon, where the action potential or the nerve impulses are initiated. The impulses are conducted to the nerve endings by the axolemma. The plasma membranes of the neurons contain integral membrane proteins that function as ion-sensitive channels for sodium ion, potassium ion, calcium ion, and chloride ions. The channels may be opened or closed in different states of neural activity. Next, we'll see about the dendrites. The dendrites are the cytoplasmic extensions of the cell body, one or more in number, and they contain the nacelle body, mitochondria, neurofilament, microtubules, and that means all the organelles of the cell body except the Golgi apparatus. The dendrites branch repeatedly and end in terminal arborizations. Numerous dendritic spines project from the terminal branches and increase the area of contact with the axons of the adjacent neurons at the synaptic junctions. Dendrites convey the impulses from the periphery to the cell body. In the cortex of the hippocampus, new dendritic spines may be formed or deleted, which is a significant feature in laying down of memory traces. Next, we'll see about the axons or the axis cylinder. Each neuron presents a single axon which arises from the axon hillock of the cell body where the nissl bodies are absent. Collateral branches arise at right angles at the sides of the axon, especially at the nodes of the ranivore in a myelinated nerve. Close to the termination, the axon branches repeatedly into small branches known as telodendria, and at the synapse, the collaterals and the terminals of the axon often forms a small swelling, bulbous swelling known as terminal knobs or boutons. Motor end plate is a special form of termination of axon in the skeletal muscle. The axon forms the structural basis of the nerve fiber within the central nervous system or in the peripheral nerves. The axon consists of axoplasm, that is a cytoplasm covered by the axolemma. The axoplasm is continuous with the cytoplasm of the soma, and they contain the neurofilaments and the microtubules which are oriented longitudinally. And it also has mitochondria, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and large number of axoplasmic vesicles. Since the axoplasm does not contain the rough endoplasmic reticulum and the ribosome granules, the nissl bodies, the axon is fully dependent on the cell body for its maintenance by the axoplasmic flow. If an axon is injured, its peripheral part degenerates and dies. Next, we'll see about the axoplasmic transport. The axoplasmic transport may be orthograde or antrograde from the cell body to the nerve endings, whereas retrograde, where it transmits from the terminal nerve endings to the cell body. The orthograde transport may be slow and fast. The slow transport is also bulk transport, which is about 0.1 to 2 millimeter per day and allows the cytoskeletal and the soluble proteins to move, but the mechanism is unknown. The fast transport, which is about 300 to 400 millimeter per day, is facilitated by the microtubules because the local treatment with colchicine abolishes the fast transport. Mitochondria appears in the axoplasm in intermittent spurts. The retrograde transport permits the worn out mitochondria and the segments of the plasma membrane to return rapidly to the cell body for degradation by the lysosome. Next, we'll see about the initial segment of the axon. The initial segment of the axon is also known as the pre-axon. So this is the interval between the axon hillock and the point at which the myelination starts. The axolemma of this segment presents several types of ion channels which regulate the conversion of graded potential into action potential, that is the nerve impulse, along the axolemma. The initial segment comes in synaptic contact with various excitatory and inhibitory neurons. The end results of such contacts modulates the transmission of the nerve impulse. Next, we'll study about the chromatolysis. Chromatolysis reflects a series of structural changes in the cell body of the neuron in response to the damage of its axon by mechanical injury or toxic agents. This phenomena is, however, reversible if the normal condition is restored within the reasonable time. What are the changes in chromatolysis? The nissl bodies degenerate and disappear due to the liberation of the acid phosphatase from the lysosome, which hydrolyzes the ribonucleoproteins. The cell body is swollen due to the increased osmotic tension of the cytoplasm, which indraws a fluid from the tissue spaces. The nucleus is eccentric in position, occupies the side of the soma opposite the axon hillock. The neurofilaments are broken into small fragments. In case of regrowth of the axon, the RNA content increases to synthesis a new protein and the nucleoli move to the periphery of the nucleus.
Thanks for watching that video.